Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to optimize a DAX expression that uses two nested iterators. Using nested iterators is always dangerous because nested iterations iterate for the multiplication of the cardinality of the base table that you use, and numbers grow up very quickly. So a very good practice is that of reducing as much as possible the size of the tables that you need to iterate on top of. But let's see that with an example, because it's much easier to understand it looking at code than with me talking. So let's go straight look at the demo. I am using our usual Contoso model, but as you can see here, I have a product discount column for each product, so each product has its own discount, and the same is happening for the customer. Each customer has a specific discount. Now, given these two numbers, now I want to compute the sales amount applying both discounts at the same time and slice it by year. I already have a report that shows the sales sliced by year. I want to add the discounted sales applying both discounts. I can compute this value in a lot of different ways, but we will author it using two nested iterators. We iterate first on customers and then on product, so that we have a row context with both columns available, and then we perform our multiplication. Let's start by writing the code. So we start with a new measure. Let's call it the discounted sales. And we iterate over customer. Then we iterate over product. We store in a variable the product discount, which is the product discount. In another variable, the customer discount. And I need the two iterations in order to have access to this column. Let's write customer discount. Then we need the sales amount. And here I just call sales amount. And finally, we can go for the return, where we take the sales amount and multiply it by 1 minus the product discount. And again, we multiply it by 1 minus the customer discount. And that's it. This code computes the discounted sales, so the sales after we have applied both discounts at the same time. We only need to format it as a decimal number, reduce its size a bit, and then we put that in the report. It takes not too long and computes the value, so we have 1.1997 and so on. So the measure by itself works, but as you have seen, it's not really super fast. You don't have the feeling that it ran very quickly, because it took 1-2 seconds to appear. And we can measure it. We can simply open view, look at the performance monitor, performance analyzer. We start recording, refresh the visual, and the query runs in around 2 seconds. Let's zoom in a bit so you can read it. It's around 2 seconds, the time needed to execute the DAX query. So it is slow. We need to understand why it is slow. In order to understand the speed, we will first try to understand what the engine does and what we ask that the engine to do. Then we will write different versions of the code until we have good performance. So let's start by doing an analysis of the code. We can get rid of the performance analyzer and just look at the code. We are asking to do one iteration over customer here and another iteration over product. Now, how many customers do we have? That I don't know, I need to check it. If we look at the customer table, we have around 18,000 customers. So these are 18,000 customers. And regarding the products, again, I don't know how many products we do have, so let me check it. We have 2,500 products. So potentially we have an outer iteration that runs 18,000 times and an inner iteration running 2,500 times. And the question is, how many times are we computing the inner calculation? That is the multiplication of the two, because for each product it will iterate every customer, and then it will repeat the process again and again. So it's not hard to do some simple math. We all just open the calculator and we have 18,000 times 2,500, that is 45 million times. So this inner iteration, this piece of code from line 6 to 10, potentially runs 40 million times. And for 40 million times, we are grabbing the values of two columns, and worse, we are performing context transition in order to compute the sales amount. That is the reason why this code is so slow. We need to rewrite it in a different way and try to optimize it. So let's do that together. But instead of working with Power BI, we move to DAX Studio because we now want to analyze performance. So let me just save it and open DAX Studio. Open in the wrong window. We need a query. So we just write something like evaluate summarize columns by date, calendar, year. And then we want amount, which is our discounted sales. Let's put it here. And while we are here, we also added the definition of discounted sales, so we have all the code available in the same window. Let's get rid of that, reduce the font. No, we need that. Okay, we open the server timings, we have our query, and we start measuring performance. We already know that will run in around 2 seconds. So we can look at the server timings and start reasoning on top of it. 1.6 seconds is the time that it takes, a lot of formula engine, a bit of storage engine, and there are three storage engine queries. Let's take a look at the storage engine queries, because you see 2,500, 18,000, these are the two queries that retrieve the list of products and the list of customers. There is nothing to look at. But then we have a query that materializes 1.8 million rows, and if we look at the code of this query, we need to reduce the font a bit. It retrieves a quantity times net price and the product key, the calendar year, and the customer key. It's retrieving all the combinations of product key, customer key, and year, which are the columns that are needed in order to resolve the query, computing the sales amount for all of them. So it actually did not iterate 45 million times, it iterated 1.8 million times because it only used the distinct combination of product key and customer key. That's exactly what we asked for. We asked it to iterate by product, by customer, then we added the year in the query, and we asked to compute the sales amount and multiply by a discount. The thing is, the query is definitely too slow. We need to find a way to avoid calling context transition, this context transition, so many times. A first option might be that of removing entirely the context transition. Why iterating over customer and product when we can iterate over sales? Because from sales, using related, we can grab the product discount and the customer discount using related to follow the relationship. Therefore, one single iteration over sales will solve the problem. Sales in this model has around 12 million rows, but iterating over 12 million rows to perform some simple calculation is not a big deal. Let's give that a try. I can change this code. Well, actually, I can do that in another window. So we still have all the values available here. We enable server timings, and in the meantime, we rewrite this code. Let's rewrite discounted sales. Instead of iterating over customer, we iterate over sales. We get rid of this second iteration. Now, product discount, I can no longer use a product discount. I need to use related. And same here, related. And get rid of that. Too many. I also now need to get rid of context transition. No way I can call context transition during an iteration over the fact table, but because I'm iterating over the fact table, I can just write sales quantity times sales net price, because now I do have a row context on the sales table. And then the return part is the same. I compute my summarized columns. Server timing is enabled. Let's run it. And it is way, way better. First of all, 58 milliseconds compared to 2000 milliseconds, that was 1,500 milliseconds, that was the value earlier. But much better, we have nearly no formula engine used here. And there is only one storage engine query. That is not easy to read, but it's basically computing the expression quantity times net price, does some rounding, and it iterates over sales, join following a join with product, with date, and with customer. So now the query is entirely executed inside storage engine, which is way better, and that's the reason why this code works way better. The thing is, removing the double iteration and replacing it with an iteration over the fact table actually required me to rewrite the entire calculation. Because if we look at the code, now I'm no longer using sales amount. I had to rewrite the expression of sales amount inside the iteration, which is not the best option, because sales amount is just a simple multiplication, but that measure can be much more complex. We need to find a way to optimize this code without rewriting entirely the code. This is not always possible, but in this specific case, it is. Let's go back to the original query. The problem is I'm iterating 18,000 rows and 2,500 rows, so a lot of rows. But do I really need to iterate over customer and product? The answer is no, I don't. Because the only column that I need is the product discount from the product table. And from customer, I only need the customer discount from the customer table. All the customers with the same discount, for the purpose of this calculation, they are the same. I can group all of them together. And the same for the product. So instead of iterating over customer, let's do that on a third window. Let's get rid of this and enable server timings also here. So instead of iterating over customer, I can iterate over values of customer discount. That's the only column that I need from the customer table. And in a similar way, I iterate over the values of product discount. Let's use single quotes just in case. The remaining part of the code is the same. I have a row context that let me access product discount, another row context for the customer discount. I can compute sales amount. The thing is, sales amount is no longer computed 45 million times. It's computed for a much smaller number of times. And most important, I'm also providing to the engine a very important information. I'm telling the engine that the cardinality of this calculation is neither the customer nor the product. It is the customer discount and the product discount. So I'm providing more information. I'm telling the engine from which column my calculation depends from. And this might turn on further optimization. Let's run the query. It doesn't work because I'm missing a comma here. Hopefully. Okay, now it run, I have my result, And it's even faster than before. Now it's 21 milliseconds. A single storage engine query, and the storage engine query does nearly the same calculation. It's a bit simpler than earlier because it computes quantity times net price, retrieving the this is named column. It's actually the customer discount, the product discount, the customer discount following the two joins. So by reducing the cardinality of the calculation, we improved the speed further. Whenever you have multiple iterations, it's always good to reduce their number as much as you can. Or try to reduce the entire calculation to only one single iteration. We can do that here because here I'm iterating over customer discount and product discount. How can I make this code with one iteration only? Well, I can actually summarize sales by customer discount and by product discount. Again, I don't need to change the inner part of the code because now this summarized part is grouping by customer discount and product discount, and then I'm iterating and doing the math. So instead of having two iterations, I now have only one iteration on two columns, only the columns that I need for my calculation. Let's give this version a try. And that is, again, 25 milliseconds. There's actually no difference between 21 and 25 milliseconds. So what we have seen are two things. First, reduce the granularity of your iterations and try to use one iteration instead of two. As you have seen, simple paying attention to simple details like this greatly improves the speed of your calculation. What comes in the mind as the first solution using multiple iterators is by far not the best one. If you are interested in learning more, go to sqlbi.com. There we have an article that describes the technique in further detail, and you can also download the file so to be able to play with it. Besides, if you like optimizations, I personally love them, we have a full training about optimizations that is definitely worth looking at. Enjoy DAX!